What did the sound guy move the mic?
I shall not fear the arrow by day, nor shall I fear the terror by night.
Sing, John.
The God who governs, angel armies, has set encampment around me. Whom shall I
take it.
thank the Lord. Thank the Lord we are here another Sabbath day. It's been a good week. Mixed emotions. We've had a verdict. We had another killing. And we had a funeral. But God is still on the throne. Well, I want to say happy Sabbath, beloved. This is Dr. George E. Thornton, Sr., coming to you once again from the Magazine Street Seventh Adventist Church, located here in Louisville, Kentucky. I'm privileged to serve as the senior pastor of this mighty fine congregation. By the way, many people do not know that the Magazine Street Church is one of the oldest historical church in Black Seventh-day Adventism. 1890, this church was founded. And so there's a lot of history within these four walls of the Magazine Street Seventh Adventist Church. And I'm just so glad that you've tuned in, you've chimed in, you have turned to this ministry once again. As you know, for the last 3 weeks, we have been dealing with what I've called transparency preaching. Transparency preaching. And we discovered that transparency preaching is when the preacher is preaching his or her process. And I've been sharing with you some of the pain, some of the struggles, some of the flaws that is draped sometimes even in the preacher. And yet, transparency preaching really moves you from the pain and the problems and all that you're struggling with to the transformation that God is able to turn one's life around. Come on, say amen, somebody. And so we've been talking about transparency preaching. And we've come today in the final installment, three sermons we gave to you. We started out with the message entitled, you remember, a knee, a leash, a rope, a noose. It's all the same thing. And we talked about that all of us, surely, those of us born of a woman, all of us have something that we have been tied to that has kept us back, that has bound us, have restricted us from having the movement that God has designed for us. And so when God told the two disciples to go and get that coat and untie him from that stationary position, and it said, if anybody asks you, why are you untying the coat? Tell them that the Lord, hey, has need of him. Oh, what a time we had with that sermon. That God is able to untangle us. He's able to untie us from those things that grip us sometimes. Our possession, our status, our jobs, our career, our finances, those things that we get wrapped up in, we get so tied up in that we fail to hear the Lord saying, I have need of you. Oh yeah, that was a beautiful sermon. And I don't know about you, but my soul was blessed. And then on last week, we dealt with the subject entitled, Quit Beating Around the Bush. We talked about the man at the pool of Bethesda. For 38 years, lying in that case, hoping that somebody would come along and help him to get into the pool that was supposed to, once he got in, that somehow they would be healed of whatever infirmities that they had. And we discovered that Jesus, out of all of those people, the halted, the blind, and the withered, of all of those maladies, he locked in on this one man who had been sitting at that pool for 38 years. And we discovered, brothers and sisters, on last week, that the reason why Jesus locked in on him, this man at the pool of Bethesda, because he had brought most of all that he was going through on himself. He was the cause of his own disease. And so by being the cause of his own problem, people began not have pity on him because he brought it on himself. Oh, you know, we get like that. Sometimes we bring stuff on ourselves. In 38 years, but Jesus said, today, He raises that question to that man. Will thou be made whole? Will thou be made whole? And the man started making excuses, and I shared with you the three excuses that the man began to share with Jesus. Even though Jesus was right there, ready to heal the man gave excuses after excuse after excuse. And Jesus came right back to the question, do you want to be made whole? And the Bible says, immediately Jesus told the man, rise, take up thy bed and walk. And we discovered that that man found a bounce in his step. He had a pep in his step. He was no longer waiting for a stimulus check. Come on, say amen, somebody. He was able to rise up. And Jesus told him, take up the bed, because the bed was to be a constant reminder of from where he had come from. Never look down on people, because lest you forget what God has done in your life. Quit beating around the bush. That was the message. And I know many of you told me, based on your chiming into the chat, into the comment section and the like, that you were blessed by that message. And I thank God for that, because I give all glory to God in all what we say and do and these messages. Well, beloved, we've come down to the last installment of the Transparency Preaching Series. And God has given me a word to share with you today. Call all your friends up. Gather your family around the table, around the dining room, in the kitchen, in the den. Maybe you may be on the porch, the weather may be nice. Maybe you are in your bedroom. Gather people around and say, the preacher got a word for you today. And so we come with another word based on transparency preaching. Well, I want to call your attention to two passages of scripture. One is found in Matthew chapter 11 and verse 12. This is a single text of scripture. Matthew chapter 11 and verse 12. And this really will be the platform, a launching pad for where we want to go based on the book of Joshua chapter 6, which we'll turn to momentarily. Matthew chapter 11 and verse 12. I want you to catch this. I want you to catch the pathos of this text. Matthew chapter 11 and verse 12 says, from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violence take it by force. Let me read that again. And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violence take it by force. And then I want to go over to the book of Joshua. Whatever translation you have, that's all right with me, as long as it's the word of God. The book of Joshua, the sixth chapter. And I want to read some verses for your consideration. Really, I want you to study the whole book of Joshua, chapter 6, verses 1 through 27. But we won't go through all of the text, but I want to read a few texts of scripture to give you the flavor, the import, where we want to go. Joshua, chapter 6. And verses, I'll read a few verses, and then we'll move into the word of God as he shall lead and guide. Now Jericho was straightway shut up because of the children of Israel. None went out, and none came in. And the Lord said unto Joshua, see, I have given unto thy hand Jericho, and the kings thereof, and the mighty men of valor. And he shall compass the city, and all you men of war, and go around about the city once. Thus shalt thou do this for 6 days. And the 7 priests shall bear before the ark 7 trumps, a ram's horn. And the 7th day ye shall compass the city 7 times, and the priest shall blow with the trumpets. And it shall come to pass that when they make a long blast with the ram's horn, and when you shall hear the sound of the trumpet, all the people shall shout with a great shout, and the walls of the city shall fall down flat, and the people shall ascend up, every man straight before him. And then I want to go down to verse 9 and then hit verse 20. Verse 9 says, and the armed men, underscore that, the armed men went before the priest that blew the trump, and the reward came after the ark, the priest going on and blowing with the trump. Let me read verse 9 again. And the armed men, went before the priest that blew the trumpets, and the reward came after the ark, and the priest going on and blowing with the trumpet. And then verse 20 says, so the people shouted with the priest, blew with the trumpet, and it came to pass that when the people heard the sound of the trumpet and the people shouted with a great shout, that the walls fell down flat. So the people went up into the city, every man straight before him, and they took, the city. I want to preach in this final installment on this series of transparency preaching, the message entitled, hear me now, Rolling Over and Playing Dead. Rolling over and playing dead. Let us bow our heads as we recognize that it's not by might nor by power, but indeed by the Spirit of the living God. Father God, we come this beautiful day to ask that you bless us. We pray that you bless your word is already blessed. Bless your people, the hearers, bless this preacher. As I share this message today that you've given me to bring before your people, we pray that nothing would hinder the transmission of this word. No hicks, no glitch, no witch, no warlock. Nothing that would stop the transmission, that somebody would hear this word today. Father, I pray you use me one more time. I tried my best to give you what you asked of me. So take this stammering tongue of mine and use me to your name's honor and glory. And oh God, somebody who's hearing, listening right now, across this airwave, somebody who's listening, may they hear the word of the Lord and may they receive the blessing that they so desperately stand in need of. Hide me behind the cross that Christ may be seen and uplifted. We'll be careful. Oh, yes, we will. As best we know how, to give you all of the praise, the honor, and the glory, because you're God all by yourself. Bind the devil now. Kick him off the premises so that you may have your way. We ask these in all blessings in the powerful name, in that name that every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that you are the Christ. In Jesus' name we pray, and all of God's children, those listening in, those who have chimed in, say amen, amen, and amen. Even though you can't see me, you can't see me physically, oh, the Spirit of God is with us. And I've said over and over again, this church is packed. It's packed because there are angels, as John started song, ushered us in, encamping about all around us. Whom shall we fear? Whom shall we be afraid? Because there are angels camped all around us. Whom shall I fear? Rolling over and playing dead. Beloved, my opening remarks may sound a bit strange to you. And here they are. Today, I want you to get violent. Violent. I want you to get as violent as you can. With all determination, with all the gusto you have, I want you to get violent. What do you mean, preacher? I want you to get so committed to the things of God that you'll withstand any attempt for somebody to try to take them away from you. Get violent. Get violent. Get committed to the things of God that you'll withstand any attempt, no matter where it comes from, that somebody tries to take it away from you. See, I've come to realize too many believers these days are like the Israelites of old. They're wandering around in the wilderness of defeat because there's an enemy in their promised land. Come on, say amen, somebody. They're being robbed of their rightful inheritance because they're afraid to fight the enemy in the land. Oh, they keep hoping that somehow they'll find a way into their promised land without using force. But let me come to tell you today, it won't happen. See, I've come to realize, I've declared today, you have to make a demand where Satan and his associates are concerned. Let me say that again. You have to make demand where Satan and his imps and associates are concerned. And the reason why I say that, because something caught my eye. When I went back to revisit the story of the promised land experience with regard to the children of Israel and God's instruction to them, something caught my attention, and I want to highlight it now. When God, hear me now, when God sent the Israelites into Canaan, he said, did you catch it in verse 9? Send the armed men to go before you. Oh my God, did you catch it? Send the armed men to go before you. They were to go up there armed, loaded, armed, ready for the fight. See, what I'm trying to get you to see, that God knew that they would have to fight to take the land. But he never promised them that they would not. But what he did promise them, and somebody needs to catch this, what he did promise them that even though they had to fight, but they would win every time. Come on, say amen, somebody. This is true for us today, brothers and sisters. You cannot roll over and play dead when you are dealing with the devil. You cannot roll over and play dead when you are dealing with the devil. See, I've come to understand in preaching my process, he is not going to let go of any area of your life, your health, your finances, your children, your marriage, your significant relationship, your house, your career, or anything else without a fight. He's not going to give up unless you force him to. Somebody better hear this preaching. He's not going to back off of you unless you force him to. It's time to quit rolling over and playing dead in the wilderness. Quit sitting there while the devil steals the blessings of God out from underneath from you. And see, I've come to declare today, hear me, somebody. You have God's permission, you have his power, you have his ability, you have his authority to take the land, to take back what the devil has stolen from you. God has given you power and authority. That's why we don't operate out of fear, but of sound mind and out of love. Whom shall I fear? You got to get violent enough to do something about it. And rolling over and playing dead like a dead dog or like a possum ain't going to cut it. Yeah, I said it. Rolling over and playing dead like a dead dog or like a possum ain't going to cut it. See, you cannot be passive in this fight. We are not dealing with a pussycat. But the Bible says a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. Did you read it in the text in Matthew chapter 11 verse 12? The kingdom of heaven suffereth violence, and the violence take it by force. See, you gotta fight for your promised land and what God has for you. You gotta fight for your family and everything that's dear to your heart. You gotta fight for it. You can't play dead. You can't roll over and give up. You gotta fight. Like Jacob, you got to say, when you're wrestling with God, you've got to say, I'm not going to let you go. I'm not going to let you go until you bless me. If I have to wrestle with you all night long, I'm not going to let you go until you bless me, Lord, until you change my name. Come on, say amen, somebody. Now, you might ask the question right here. Why do I have to fight so hard for something already given to me? Because the text says in the beginning of Joshua chapter 6 that God said, I have already given Jericho into thy hand, and all their mighty men, I have given you everything already. So if God has given it to us already, why do we have to fight for it? Or put it another way. If Jesus won the battle, why am I or are we still fighting? It's a good question. See, what you need to understand, in this warfare, we've been talking about this for some time now, this spiritual warfare, that Jesus won the battle, but the war is still raging, brothers and sisters. And you cannot roll over and play dead. You got to fight onward. Onward, Christian soldiers. Fighting as to war. You got to fight. This ain't no checkered game. This ain't no tick for tat toe. You got to fight. And I've discovered in my transparency preaching in my own life, battles are fought every day. From the time you wake up until the time you go to bed, even while you sleep, battles are being fought. A great warfare is going on over every soul between the prince of darkness and the prince of light. There's a great battle to be fought that the inhabitants of the world may be warned of the great day of the Lord, and that the stronghold of the enemy may enter, that all who love the Lord may be gathered under the blood-stained banner of Prince Emmanuel. But see, fighting for what is yours sometimes is not easy. It's hard. But make no mistake about it, brothers and sisters, it's a fight. But let me put it in context. The difference is that we are not fighting in our own ability. Come on, say amen, somebody. Rather, we're fighting from a position of victory, not from a position of trying to get victory. Victory is already out. Jesus has already won it. We've just got to make sure we stay on the winning side. Hallelujah. We know that the enemy is roaring around, seeking whom he may devour. But catch this. He cannot devour you when you are aware. That's a word from somebody. He cannot devour you when you are alert, when you are aware. That's why the Bible says, be sober, be vigilant. For your adversary, the devil, walketh about as a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. And he has no respect of person, no respect of family, no respect of age, whether you're church or unchurched. You got to make sure that you stay alert. You're talking about staying woke. You got to stay woke when it comes to the devil. He cannot devour you when you are aware, when you are alert. Yes, fighting sometimes, brothers and sisters, it's hard. I ain't lying, it's hard. You say to yourself, when is it going to end? But see, you can't give up. You can't roll over. You can't play dead. I don't care how tough the battle gets. See, we've got to fight with the grace of God that is within us. We must fight what they call the good fight of faith. See, I want to take you to somewhere. When you read Joshua chapter 5 and verse 6, and chapter 6, by the way, pardon me, Joshua went forth in the morning before taking of Jericho. Notice in verse 5, chapter 5, and verses 13, 14, and 15, the Bible said there appeared before him a warrior fully equipped for battle. That's what the verse said. Read verses 13, 14, and 15 in Joshua chapter 5. Now here's what you got to understand. If the eyes of Joshua had been opened as were the eyes of the servant Elijah at Dothan, Joshua would have seen the angel of the Lord encamped about the children of Israel. That's why we use that song by John Stoddard and Aeolians. Whom shall I fear? For trained, listen to this, for trained army of heaven had come to fight for the people of God. Yo, somebody should shout right there. Trained army of heaven had come to fight for the people of God. The captain of the Lord's host was there to command everything, had everything under control. Come on, say amen, somebody. Now watch this. Note, it says, when Jericho fell, when Jericho fell, what's your Jericho? When Jericho, that city fell, what's your Jericho? What do you need for the Lord to collapse in your life? What do you need for the Lord to strike down in your life? What do you need for the Lord to get rid of in your life? When Jericho fell, now watch this. The prolific writer says, no human hand touched the walls of the city. Did you get it? They went up armed for the fight, but no human hand touched the walls of the city, for the angel of the Lord overthrew the fortification and entered the fortress of the enemy. We read these words. It was not Israel. Check this out now. It was not Israel, but the captain of the Lord's host that took Jericho. Oh, somebody ought to be starting to shout right now. I don't care what scrimmage you have, what battle you're going through. This battle is not yours. It belongs to the Lord. If you stay on God's side, he will fight your battles. He fights your battles. He fights my battles. It was not Israel, but the captain of the Lord's host that took the city of Jericho. But, catch this. Israel had their part to play, and it was not to roll over and play dead, but to show their faith in the captain of their salvation. Don't put your confidence in yourself, in your ingenuity, in your education, in your degrees, in your networking skills. Don't put your confidence in man. Put your confidence in the captain of your salvation. Why? Because Jesus knows the territory. He knows the ground. He had been through this battle before. And plus, he knows the enemy. Have you forgotten he was defeated? There was war in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon. And that text says in Revelation, but the devil prevailed not. Oh, thank you, Jesus. The devil prevailed not. And if you allow God to fight your battles, you can be victorious. This is no time to shrink back. This is no time to roll over and play dead. Somebody needs to hear this. The Lord is on our side. Many times you find yourselves in an impossible situation and you don't know how you're going to get out of it. Your back's against the wall. I've been there many a times. It may be your finances. It may be your family. It may be your health. It may be your circumstances of habit. But whatever it is, you must fight with prayer. Hear me. With prayer, with fasting, studying God's word, communing with him daily, pleading with him, agonizing with him, studying his word. Everything that you care about, you must lay it on the altar of prayer and sacrifice. Holding on to God's word and his promise. This is a spiritual battle. You know that. And we do not fight him with our own weapons, carnal weapons, and our own carnal nature. The battle is not yours, but the Lord. Notice how God sent those mighty warrior down to Joshua. And Joshua says to them, are you for us or are you our adversary? And they responded to Joshua that we are here representing the captain of the Lord's host. And we're here to make sure you win. Now, when you allow the angels of the Lord to take over the operation of your life, guess what, baby? Victory is yours. Somebody need this word. When you allow the angel of the Lord to take over the operation of every area, every situation of your life, victory, it can be assured, victory is yours. Oh yeah, God has a plan for us. If you have a pulse, you have a purpose. Find it and live it out. Fight the good fight of faith. Here's what I'm trying to tell you. I'm not going to be long with this. Here's what I'm trying to tell you. It's time to go over and not to roll over. Oh, somebody got to get this. It's time to go over into your promised land and not roll over. And to take what God has given you. I don't know about you, but I'm sick and tired of the devil messing with my family. And I've declared today, I had to draw a line in the sand and declare to Satan, you cannot have my mind. My mind belongs to Jesus. My body belongs to Jesus. Like Paul says, I beseech you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, that you present your body as a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. Be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, so that you may prove what is good, perfect, and the acceptable will of God. And you got to declare to Satan, you have no authority. This is the last time I'm giving you legal rights to me, my family and my children, my health and my finances and my emotions. In fact, I have filed a restraining order against you through the Holy Ghost. No time to roll over and play dead. It's time to leave the past behind and move into the new things that God has in store for you. I want you to catch something now. And I saw this as I was reading and studying. Before the children of Israel entered into the promised land, note, they were following miracles, but now miracles are following them. Or somebody better stay woke. Before the children of Israel entered into the promised land, they were following miracles, but now miracles follow them. Did you hear that? In other words, one victory after another, Jericho and the other Ai, all the other giants in that land were conquered because they had the Lord on their side. That's why the song says, victory. Victory belongs to Jesus. Who can come against him? No one can. Who can defeat Jesus? No one can. And brothers and sisters, in this transparency preaching, I've been trying to tell you that when you give yourself wholly over to God, victory can be yours. You don't have to give up. You don't have to roll over and play dead. Stand in the power and the promises of God and in the power of his word. Stand. And don't let nobody stop you from going after what God has promised you shall have. Hey! Victory! Who will stand against the Lord? No one can.
No one will.
No one will. Hey! Who will stand against the king? No one can. Listen to this song. Listen to it, brothers and sisters. I'm trying to encourage somebody today. Victory belongs to Jesus. Aren't you glad about that? Aren't you glad that victory is already yours? You just got to stand behind the Lord Jesus Christ. Stand under the bloodstained banner. No one can come up against you when you send Jesus to the front door. Come on, say amen, somebody. No one can. No one can.
So the victory belongs to Jesus.
Victory belongs to Jesus. Hey, I'm already on the winning side. Hey, I'm already on the winning side. Woo, I feel mighty good right now. I'm already on the winning side. Hey! Victory belongs to Jesus.
We put it all on your shoulders. Victory belongs.
Yeah. Listen to those words. Put your trust in him. put your hope in him. Hey! Woo! Oh yeah! I feel my help coming. Hey! Calvary is coming. Fight your battles and my battles. We can find peace in Jesus. Hey! Woo! Victory! Victory! I dare you shout in your home, victory! Victory! Victory belongs to Jesus. Yes, it does. No matter what it looks like, no matter how dark it is, no matter what the odds, victory, hey, belongs to Jesus. Come on, say amen, somebody. Victory belongs. Woo! Victory belongs.
Come on, if you got any Christian right here, say the victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs.
You ought to lift your hands. You ought to raise your hands and say, thank you, Lord, for being on my side. If it had not been for the Lord on my side, where would I be? I'd be lost. No matter what your Jericho is, God has already given you the promised land. You got to go up and fight and get it. But you got to fight the good fight of faith. And then I'm going to give you two for one. Because as we talk about victory belongs to Jesus, then you got to understand something. Faithful is our God. Faithful is our God. We are reaping the harvest, what God has promised me and you, and taking back what the devil has stole from us. From victory to reaping the harvest and what the Lord has promised, because faithful, hey, there it is. There it is. Woo! Woo! Faithful.
Faithful.
You ought to be shouting right now.
Faithful.
Faithful
is our God.
Faithful,
ha! Faithful, faithful is our God. Woo! Faithful,
faithful,
faithful, faithful is our God.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
Faithful,
faithful,
faithful, faithful is our God.
Yeah, 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 yeah. I'm reaping the harvest. I'm taking back what the devil has stolen from me. I rejoice today. Hey!
I shall recover it all.
Come on, shout with me. Shout with me. Devil, you cannot have my children. You cannot have my family.
Faithful,
hey!
Faithful.
I don't know about you.
Faithful.
Faithful.
Faithful
is my God.
Faithful.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Guess what? I'm reaping the harvest. I'm taking back what the devil has stolen from me. I rejoice. I'm in George today.
I shall.
Yeah. coming. I feel it coming. I shall recover it all. I feel it. I feel it coming. Hallelujah. Woo! Faithful.
Faithful.
Come on, somebody say faithful. Faithful.
Faithful.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
Faithful.
Not me, but him.
Faithful, faithful is
yes, sir.
Our God.
Yes, sir.
Faithful.
Faithful.
Faithful, faithful is our God.
I'm reaping the harvest.
God promised me. Take back what
the devil has stolen
from me. And I rejoice.
I'm rejoicing.
Today.
Because I know. I see it coming. The Calvary is coming. I see it.
Yes, I rejoice.
Won't you rejoice with me? We can recover it all.
Woo.
Holy
is our God.
Oh, yeah. I'm getting excited up here.
Holy is our God.
The possibilities of God. Oh, I need you to pray now. I'm about to bust wide open. Reaping the harvest. I'm taking back. He stole from us. And I'm rejoicing today. I shall recover it all. Hey! And you can recover it too. You don't have to roll over and play dead. You don't have to roll over and play dead.
Jesus
is the captain
of our
battle. Somebody better hear me. I'm going to pray right now. Because somebody needs to be assured that you can recover it all. You can get back what the devil has stolen from you. And he's taken a lot. I know. He's taken a lot from me. He's taken a lot from my family. He's taken a lot from my children. He's taken a lot from my peace. But today, devil, I'm taking it back because of Jesus is faithful. You can't roll over and play dead. I'm drawing a line in the sand. Hither and no further, devil. And you wanna hook up with me right now. You wanna say, preacher, I'm tired of rolling over and playing dead. I'm tired of the devil taking advantage of me. I need to get on the Lord's side. I need him to fight my battle. And all I've got to do is to fight the good fight of faith. Pray, study, stay with him day in and day out. And victory can be assured. Oh, Father God, Lord, the devil, he doesn't play fair. He tried to take everything good from us. But today, oh God, we have placed a restraining order against him. A restraining order that will keep him back from us through the Holy Spirit. Father, somebody today needs to recover what the devil has stolen from them. And so, Lord, we lift up your name. Because faithful is our God. The old hymn writer says, great is thy faithfulness. All that I've ever needed, your hands have provided it. summer, winter, springtime, or fall. Father, that mother is listening to me right now. The devil has stolen her children, incarcerated in addictions and drugs. For that mother and that father, Lord, help them to know that they're going to reap, get them all back. Pray for that marriage that's been on the rock like a drunken man, reeling like a drunken man. Put joy back into their love, to their marriage. Put hope back into their marriage. There's somebody standing up on give up ground. They're about to roll over and play dead. Lord, revive them right now. Build their spirit up, God. Somebody needs a job. Somebody needs a career. Somebody needs finances. Lord, let them know it's coming. It's coming. It's coming. They will reap the harvest. Just got to stay hold of God's unchanging hand. Oh, Father, we've got to be honest. There's some stuff he stole from us, but there's some stuff we gave him as well. Lord, we want to take all of it back. Restore what the locusts have eaten up. Restore. Renew. Revive. Transform. Change. May our latter be better than our former. I pray for this church. Pray for every family, every home that's been battling the devil in their own armor. Lord, now we understand that you got mighty angels standing in the gap. And all we've got to do is fight the good fight of faith. Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. We're going to get it all back. I feel it already. I see it happening. Don't you see it happening? Can't you hear the cavalry coming? Beloved, don't give up. Do not cast away your confidence. He that will come shall come, and he will not tarry. Ride on, King Jesus, ride on. And then Father, cleanse us from our sins. Purge us with his son. Create us a clean heart and renew a right spirit so that we can rejoice in what the Lord has done in our lives. Oh, I shall recover it all. All of God's children, all of God's children, all of God's children, say amen, amen, and amen. Well, beloved, what a word today. What a word today. No time to roll over and play dead. Victory belongs to Jesus. That's all I've been trying to tell you in this transparency preaching. No matter how bad it looks, no matter how difficult the struggle, if you hold on to God's unchanging hand, here's the scripture, 2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if any man or woman be in Christ, he or she is a new creation, and all things are made new. Beloved, now we are the sons and daughters of God. It does not yet appear what we shall be. Ah, but I do know this one thing. When Christ shall appear, for we shall be like him, and for we shall see him just as he is. May God bless you. May God keep you. As we look forward to a new series that the Lord has given me, we will share with you next week. Until then, stay behind the captain of your salvation. When the devil comes to the front door, tell him that you are under new management. God bless you.